Hi everybody, this is Dave Vellante. We're here at the New York Stock Exchange for a very special CUBE conversation. Really appreciate you joining us today, where we're exploring how two key companies in the AI era, Nvidia and Dell, are working together to really more rapidly accelerate AI across enterprises, and specifically the role that storage engines play in doing so. A lot of times people forget about the data in the storage, so I want to dive right in. Darren Miller is here. He's the technical staff member for unstructured data storage. That's where all the action is in AI over at Dell Technologies. And Matheen Raza is a product marketing lead for enterprise AI at Nvidia. Gentlemen, thanks for coming in remotely. I wish you were here face to face, but really a pleasure to have you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Dave.
You bet. All right.
Happy to be here.
Let's get into the role of data in AI and storage, the impact that that plays. And Darren, as we always talk about AI, it's only as good as the data that serves it, that powers it. You know, Jeff Clark had a very spicy statement last year this past year at DTW to that regard. You got to deliver it rapidly, efficiency. How do you describe Dell's approach to data management?
Sure, Dave. So you mentioned Dell's storage engine, and PowerScale is one of the core platforms of Dell's AI storage engine. When you think about Dell's data management approach, it's really an approach of three pillars of place, protect, and process. And essentially what that means is we help you place your data on high performance, powerful storage systems. And then that allows these different AI workflows to then process that data for, you know, depending on whether the workflow is a RAG workflow or training or fine tuning, whatever it might be. And then ultimately enabling protection of that data so that you have essentially that total data lifecycle. If you think of how we're doing this with NVIDIA, one of the things that we've been working really hard at is to continue to produce reference designs co-developed by Dell and NVIDIA based on the NVIDIA different AI platforms that they're serving, such as SuperPOD, enterprise storage certifications, as well as NCP, which is NVIDIA's cloud partner program. So we've really been involved in bringing our storage to those platforms and those programs to help build confidence for customers that want to run large scale AI infrastructures.
So thank you for that, Darren. Mateen, I mean, NVIDIA obviously is leading the AI charge. You've got a highly well thought out integrated stack. And so from your perspective, you've got to certify the solutions for customers. You've got the NV Cert program. What does that mean for storage providers, and specifically, what's the value for customers?
Yeah, definitely. So let me talk a little bit about this, right? And let me take a step back and talk about this concept of AI factory and or AI factories, right? As you know, where enterprises are building AI workloads and experimenting with AI, we are seeing them, or you know, we see this need for rethinking how a data center is built and how a data center is operated, right? With the rise of, you know, we see every different workload is going to get accelerated, and enterprises need to start looking at these data centers not just as a cost center where you're running your applications, but as an engine that takes data and electricity as inputs and delivers output as tokens. And these tokens are then, you know, these are the intelligence that you're delivering to your end users or your internal customers that that eventually deliver business value. Now, I talked about the AI factory, you know, in the concept, but there's a variety of different AI factories. You could have an AI factory that's focused on large-scale training, large-scale inference, and there's the enterprise AI factory that's supporting a variety of different accelerated computing workloads. But in each of these, one of the key inputs to an AI factory is data. And of course, with this, we also see needs for new integrations, and we communicate those integrations as part of our reference architectures, and partners such as Dell take those components and innovate on their end and build out these solutions for end customers.
You know, I think the point you made, Matheen, is key, because 10, 15 years ago, everybody was saying, let's get rid of the data center. It's a cost center, and You're talking about turning it into a profit center. We wrote a piece at theCUBE Research recently, you know, the new Jensen's new law, buy more, save more. It actually talked about where power is a constraint and network utilization is low, you can actually monetize in a new way. And so it's a completely different mindset when you bring in extreme parallel processing or what you guys like to call accelerated computing. And I want to tie that into storage performance. And I got a question for both of you. I'll start with Matheen. When you're feeding GPUs with the right data, you got to have it, you know, almost real time, near real time, even real time. How do your two companies, Dell and Nvidia, how do you approach that challenge of being able to keep that data streaming, feeding the GPUs so that they stay highly utilized, so you're not sort of wasting that critical resource? Matheen, I wonder if you could start.
Yeah, for sure. You know, one of the things is that we're not just accelerating the AI workloads, but we're accelerating a variety of different workloads. And one of these, you know, a set of these include data prep, right? So things like accelerating Spark with Rapids and helping those workloads run faster, or accelerating vector indexing with QVS and other, you know, other CUDA, what we call the CUDA X libraries that accelerate the workflow either in the data prep or post preparation of data, basically accelerating a variety of different workloads, right? And we see that the enterprise data management or the storage systems need to be able to deliver these data pipelines to these workloads, to these accelerated computing workloads, whether it's a high performance computing workload, whether it is a training workload or an inference workload, making sure that these GPUs that you have the right amount of data can operate on that real-time data. Now that is making sure that, it's the analogy that I kind of use is that if you're using a sports car, you don't want to drive it on inside streets and, you know, drive it at low speed. You want to make sure that you're maximizing the utilization of your sports car and be able to drive it and have the speeds, the high-speed roads. In this case, the analogy would be the networking and the high-performance storage to be able to power your sports car power your AI use cases with the right amount of data.
Okay, thank you. And Darren, I wonder if you could give us your perspective from Dell's point of view.
Yeah, sure. So Matheen actually hit it right on the head. From the software stack, CUDA X, Rapids, Spark, that's pulling in data and it's accessing data at a rapid rate. You know, regardless of whether it's for, you know, regardless of the workflow that's being run there, these libraries and these technologies are demanding data at a high speed. So it's from our perspective, from Dell's perspective, especially on the storage side, we need to provide that data at a rapid rate and at a high performance rate. And engineering advances in the past 2 to 3 years at Dell have provided more than double performance in a lot of our products, including file and object storage. We've increased the capability to have higher capacity systems with the introduction of 122 terabyte size disks. And, you know, gains in improvements like this not only just give us things to brag about for the most part, but also they provide the infrastructure that's needed for these high performance workloads and the applications in the software stacks that are demanding that data at a rapid rate.
Okay, let's talk about RAG workloads and the intelligence, the metadata intelligence around that. I'll start with Matheen. Retrieval augmented generation, it's become sort of mainstream. I mean, people realize, wow, I got this corpus of data, I can vectorize it, I can, you know, do the embedding, and I can actually have an intelligent assistant and chatbot, and I could serve customers better, I can serve my internal needs better. It's so many use cases. So it's become a critical enterprise workload. How is it evolving and why, Matheen, is it so important today?
Yes, absolutely. It goes back to generative AI, right? Ever since it's come into the market, it's been the most transformative technology of our generation, right? And pretty much every function what we're seeing is going to be infused with AI to enhance what we're doing on a daily basis. But you know, however good these models are, they need the enterprise context, they need the data, and this is where data becomes a critical piece. Otherwise, these models are not going to be efficient and they're not really going to deliver the value that they're intended to deliver. And RAG is a great way to augment that knowledge base. But for these agents or for these use cases, you want to make sure that you have the most current, the freshest data available for the models to make their predictions and deliver those responses, and from there on drive outcomes out of that as well. And what we're seeing happen is, as enterprises start using or building with this, we're seeing each team building their own RAG pipeline. They start copying data over and do so multiple times, and you know, essentially creating sprawl and bloat of data within the organization. It's not just inefficient, it also opens security and accuracy issues, like, which can really lead to some data privacy and compliance issues in most organizations. So this is where we're seeing a new class of storage infrastructure emerge, right, to support the needs of these AI workloads. And we announced this as part of our initiative called NVIDIA AI Data Platform, which is a customizable reference design where we work with our partners such as Dell to build solutions that deliver, you know, we're starting with RAG, but deliver these AI pipelines for these enterprise AI workloads.
And Darren, I mean, we know from our own experience using theCUBE AI and our own, you know, RAG-based interfaces and chatbots, you can't just throw it out there and expect it all to work. You've got to classify it. You've got to have, you know, strong indexing. You've got to have your metadata act together. You've got to have, you know, performance tuning. How are you guys addressing that and adding value to the portions of the solution that Matheen just talked about?
Yeah, you know, we've talked a lot about storage efficiencies and performance and advances, as well as, you know, increased capacity capabilities. But one thing we haven't spoke of is metadata. And if you think of RAG workflows and being able to retrieve that data on a extremely efficient rate to reduce, you know, lag time on responses and things like that, metadata is key. We recently announced a technology within the OneFS file system called Metadata IQ. And what Metadata IQ does is it essentially enhances classification of data, indexes your metadata in a way where it's easily read, it's easily accessible through these mechanisms like the RAG workflows and LangChain and things like that, mm-hmm. Which again, you know, is another level of efficiency. And brings that efficiency to the specific workflow instead of the data in general, right? Another thing that we recently announced was the PowerScale RAG connector. And essentially what the RAG connector does is it further enhances that capability of accessing the data, because the connector knows exactly where the data is placed within OneFS through our metadata mechanisms and Metadata IQ, and then allows lookup and retrieval rates to be even more efficient based off of the knowledge that that RAG connector has within the OneFS file system.
Guys, it's been a great conversation. Oh, go ahead. You had. Please, carry on, Darren.
No, the only thing I was going to finish with was that the other thing that helps these workflows is integration with NVIDIA's NIM services. And being able to tie that into the workflow, like almost organically, if you will, through different connectors and different technologies that enable those workflows.
Thank you for adding that. The NIMS microservices are key. Guys, I really appreciate your time. I wonder if you could give us sort of, put a bow on this conversation, just give us final thoughts. Maybe Darren, you could start, and then Matheen, you can bring us home.
Yeah, sure. I think the only thing I'll finish with is, first off, thank you, Dave, for hosting. It's been a pleasure, as usual. We are hosting a Dell AI Data Platform event where we'll be showcasing new innovations within the Dell AI Data Platform, customer case studies, as well as specific workflows that will help customers to build better AI within their organizations. And we'll be showcasing some joint solutions with NVIDIA.
Matheen, your final thoughts?
Yeah, this has been a great conversation. Thank you for having me. And if you're looking to simplify, scale, and accelerate your AI within your organization, the Dell AI Data Platform event is the event to be at. And you know, we are really excited to continue our work with Dell and continue to push boundaries to deliver innovative solutions to our customers. Thank you.
Guys, thank you. Look, this is a complicated situation for a lot of customers, particularly in enterprises that you know have really, frankly, been relying on the cloud for many years for their infrastructure. They need solutions. You know, the big hyperscalers, they've got the skills. They can throw engineering time and money at the problem. Customers need solutions, and partnerships like this are critical. So I really appreciate you guys getting together and sharing with us what you guys are doing, and look forward to having you back. There's more coming later this fall on October 21st, the Dell AI Data Platform event, which is hosted by theCUBE. And so look for that on thecube.net and on Dell's website, dell.com. Thank you guys, really appreciate your time.
Thank you.
All right, and thank you for watching. This is Dave Vellante for theCUBE, and we'll see you next time.